Jacob here with Sarracenia Northwest. In this video, I'm going to show you how to avoid the most common mistakes when repotting Sarracenia, Venus flytraps, and hardy Sundews during the growing season. The biggest problem with repotting outdoor perennials during the growing season is root disturbance. If you disturb the roots too much, they will sometimes stop growing for a while. In a worst case scenario, they might even die. And we've heard from many growers who have experienced that trauma of seeing a plant die after repotting it during the growing season. The most sensitive plants are hardy Sundews. They despise excessive root disturbance during the growing season. Once they come out of dormancy and they're actively growing, it's best to leave them alone. Venus flytraps are also sensitive to root disturbance. Not as much as Sundews are, but they often stop producing new traps if their roots are disturbed too much. However, the red dragon flytrap is very sensitive to root disturbance, and these plants often die when mishandled during the growing season. So this is one variety of the Venus flytrap that you'll need to treat like a hardy Sundew. Sarracenia represent the most resilient of the bunch. They can handle some root disturbance without being too affected. I've never seen a Sarracenia die from being repotted during the growing season. At most, I've seen them stop growing for about a month before resuming pictures again. So the best times to repot these plants is when they're dormant, during fall, winter, and early spring. Here at the nursery, we do the bulk of our repotting in early spring, March and April. But sometimes you just need to repot these plants during the growing season. Here's a bed to bog garden that I've been wanting to complete for the past year. I've just been too busy when these plants were dormant, but I have time now. However, it's June and these plants are actively growing. So I'm going to show you how to place these plants into a bog garden without setting them back or killing them. So I've selected my plants and place them where I want them. I'm going to start with the Sarracenias first. It's a lot easier to work with the larger plants and then work backwards to the smaller plants. So this plant here is a Sarracenia hybrid called Barry. I'm going to make a hole that's just big enough to fit the pot in, and you'll see why in just a moment. It'll go in just like that. Now, to minimize root disturbance on this plant, I'm going to turn it upside down just like this and remove the pot. And you can see some of the roots there, and place the entire mass of soil into that hole, just like that. And make sure it's oriented in the direction that you want it. And there we go. And the process is very similar to all of the Sarracenias. Now this plant too has lots of Sundews in it. This is a particular hybrid, one of ours that came up from seed. It lacks a lot of chlorophyll, so it is mostly white. It's very slow growing. We don't have a name for it. This plant is maybe about 6 years old, so it's not very fast growing, but it is in our collection. And when you have your plant unpotted like this, it's really good to do the sniff test. The soil should smell earthy. There shouldn't be any funk to it. If it smells like sulfur or rotten eggs or any funky odor, you will need to do a complete repot, changing the soil and everything. It's not optimal to do it during the growing season, but if you have unhealthy soil, you have unhealthy soil and you need to take care of it. But that soil smelled very good. Next, we're gonna set the flytraps into the bog garden. The flytraps are not as sensitive with root disturbance as Sundews, but you do not want to disturb the roots too much. Of course, I've got to make my hole first. There we go. And there's some roots sticking out here. I'm just going to get them out of the way, out of the drain hole, so I can unpot the plant just like that. So you keep everything intact and set that in just like that. There's some weeds there. Pull out the weeds, but everything looks good, and there you go. Now it's snug in there. Now finally we can do the Sundews. This is a dew thread, and they're very sensitive to root disturbance during the growing season. So we're gonna have to be very careful in making sure that the roots remain undisturbed and all the soil around it remains intact. So carefully turn it upside down, loosen up the pot, and set that in just like that. There we go. That was a very gentle process, and that plant will be very happy in this bog garden. Now, if you want to know how I set up this bat to bog garden, I did a video about it a couple of years ago. You can find that link in the description below. Now, finally, I have two Sarracenias here of the same variety. This is Alada, Red Hood variety. Now, one of the mistakes I see new growers make, and it's particularly new growers because they don't have a frame of reference of how to repot Sarracenia, they often repot it too low. The plant here on the left, the rhizome is well below the soil level, and this is too low. This is the incorrect way of repotting Sarracenia. The plant on the right, this is the proper way to replant a Sarracenia. The crown of the plant, and the crown is the point of where the new growth comes out, that needs to be above the soil line. And a rhizome, again, is a stem that grows along the soil line. And so the rhizome needs to be, part of it needs to be above the soil. If it's below the soil line, the crown will want to get above the soil line and it will begin to elongate. And I did a video about that, and you can find the link to that video in the description below. But the plant here on the left, that is set too low. And a lot of growers write to us wondering why their plant isn't growing as well. Well, this is the reason why it's set too low. So we're gonna change this plant. Let's unpot this plant and repot it into the correct way, such as this way. All right, I removed the plant from the soil, and this is what the rhizome looks like. This plant has 1, 2, 3, 4 crowns, and you can see the new growth coming up. And again, the crown needs to be above the soil line. A rhizome is a stem that grows along the soil. So if it's too deep in the pot, the plant can't clump up. The rhizome can't grow sideways. It's going to grow upwards instead. So you want to keep the crowns, the growing points, above the soil line. And that's very important. So we're going to secure the plant by pushing the soil around the roots, just like this. And there we go. This is the proper presentation when repotting a Sarracenia. And you can see now it looks just like the other one. Now I went ahead and finished off the bog garden by top dressing it with some decorative pea gravel. The pea gravel is going to help retain soil moisture and prevent soil erosion when I'm top watering during the growing season. Now, if you need further assistance in growing your carnivorous plants, visit our website, growcarnivorousplants.com, and look for the Ask the Growers link. You can also read our care guides and watch our videos, especially our monthly care videos. And while you're on our website, check out the inventory to see what's in stock. Thank you so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you in another video.